Hello friends, and welcome to the Tom Photo channel. I recently made a video about the wonderful but not entirely flawless Nikon D3400, and I promised to talk about its kit lens sharpness in more detail. Now I'm keeping my promise. What I'm about to tell you will apply to both the D3400 and D3500, and the results might surprise you. So here's my D3400 with a kit lens, the hero of today's video. It's a great camera, capable of high quality photography. The active D-lighting and really nice RAW files offer pleasing dynamic range. The kit lens is an 18-55mm f-stop range, 3.5-5.6. Nothing surprising or uncommon so far. The lens is made of plastic and has a locking button you press to turn the lens to wake it up. The lens has no other buttons, such as those to turn on and off the wonderful image stabilization that it has, or switch to manual focusing. The lens is controlled entirely by the body. A nice feature is definitely the quiet lens motor that is used for focusing. But how sharp is the lens, and what is its sweet spot? I have posted a video previously on how I measured lens sweet spot, and the link is below. There are many things you have to be mindful of. For example, you have to use a tripod and photograph something flat, such as this painting, for example. But here I determined the sweet spot at three different focal lengths, 18, 35, and 55 millimeters. Here's the 18 millimeter result. The sweet spot occurs at f-stop 11. Anything at 5.6 all the way to 16 seems to be a good choice. Going to 35mm, you'll notice that the second half of the graph is becoming a plateau. Really? Why? The sweet spot is still at f11, but for some reason the diffraction and other problems are not kicking in at larger f-stop values. This is surprising to me. You can go all the way to f-stop 22 and nothing terrible is happening. This is a major contrast to all other lenses whose sweet spot I have measured. Those have been primarily Fuji lenses, though. And a note before I go on, you cannot compare the absolute sharpness values of different focal lengths because at each focal length, you essentially photograph a different image. So you're always comparing relative sharpness values. Let's go to 55mm and the picture is even more convincing. Anything after f-stop 11 gives you practically the same result. Amazing! Where is the diffraction to cause softness of image? This lens is so different from all Fuji lenses that I own. Now I want to emphasize that lens sweet spot is not to be confused with depth of field. They both influence image sharpness, but are not the same as image sharpness. Lens sweet spot applies only when you talk about a specific point in the scene and how sharp you can make it. Depth of field shows how many different objects that are different distance from the camera are in focus. Depth of field becomes greater when you increase the f-stop. You typically cannot increase f-stop to the very limit because lens aberrations and diffraction get in the way. Apparently not with this lens. Does that make this lens a perfect landscape lens where you have close and distant objects that all have to be sharp? It certainly looks like this. Let me know in the comments what your opinion is on this. So here's my take-home message for you, showing the best aperture values to choose for maximal single-point sharpness. F-stop 11 will always work and is a safe bet. The longer the focal length, the smaller you can go with the aperture. Whatever the focal length, you can relatively bravely go to the crazy f-stop of 22. So there you have it. Thank you for tuning in to Tom Photo channel. I hope to see you again soon in my other videos where I talk about photography related matters. Have a great day.